Today marks the third day of our 7 days. And gradually, we are getting refined.
Yes.
Because one of the characteristics of fire is to refine. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our God is a consuming fire. When he touches our life, he transforms and he refines our life.
Amen.
And I know that in those 7 days, God is bringing a refinery into your life.
Amen.
God is making you the finest. Hallelujah. He is making you who you are supposed to be. He is bringing something good in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, when we talk about season, we simply mean that we are preserving something.
That's right.
Something must be preserved.
Amen.
Your life must be preserved.
That's right.
And whenever we preserve something, it means that we are keeping that thing to last long. Amen. Everybody person who bought for so many bar. Everybody person who yet a doom when I saw him. So when we preserve, it means that you become lasting. When we preserve, it means that you add value to something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you go to the sea and you buy fish at the seashore, it's very cheap, right? You can get a basket of fish at a very cheap price. But when it has been transported home and it has been preserved, it has been put on fire a little bit, and you go once again to buy, you buy it at a very expensive price. It means that value has been added to that commodity. I pray that in those 7 days, may God add value to your life.
Amen.
God is bringing fire to add value to your life.
Amen.
Your life will not be ordinarily again.
Amen.
Your life will move to a different dimension.
Amen.
Because you have been seasoned with fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you season something, you make it very attractive. You make it attractive. It becomes so nice. It becomes so beautiful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the fire make you attractive.
Amen.
When you are rejected because of the fire, may you be accepted.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tonight, we want to look at the God who answers by fire. The God who answers by fire. Our God is a God of fire. And fire is a symbol of God. We serve in a God who speaks. We serve in a God who acts. We serve in a God who answers by fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to read our first scripture from 1 Kings chapter 17. 1 Kings chapter 17. We'll read the verse 1. Then we'll continue from the chapter 18. We'll be reading from the verse 26 to the verse 39. First Kings chapter 17, verse 1. The God who answers by fire. Now Elijah, who was from Tishbe in Gilead, told King Ahab, "As surely as the Lord, the God of Israel lives, and the God I serve, there will be no dew or rain during the next few years until I give the word." Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Other verses say that according to my word. This is Elijah making a very bold declaration before King Ahab. Now, when you read the Bible, this is the first time we are hearing about Elijah. The first mention of this man in the Bible. The Bible did not give us much about his background. Where Elijah came, how Elijah was born, we don't know. We don't know the parents of Elijah. But he just appeared in the scene, making a declaration. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He just appeared. Somebody say, "He appeared."
He appeared.
After these 7 days, you appear and you make a declaration.
Amen.
So when you fast and pray, you go and hide. And when you are hiding, you are receiving authority and power. The moment you show up in the scene, you must declare.
Amen.
So in these 7 days, you will declare.
Amen.
After 7 days, you will declare.
Amen.
And when you declare, it shall be established.
Amen.
The guy just appeared in the scene, boom, one time. He just breaks forth into the scene, making a declaration. And the Bible says that he is from Tishbe in Gilead. Now, when you look at the map, it's a very obscure place, a very unknown town. That is where the guy is coming from. So when you have the fire of God, it brings you from obscurity to the lamplight.
Amen.
The fire of God brings from obscurity to the what? Lamplight. I pray that in those 7 days, may the Lord take you to the lamplight.
Amen.
And running from you, know, baby, I'll bring home any departure through it, you know. Because something has passed through your life.
Amen.
The fire will not hide you, the fire reveals. The fire reveals. Hallelujah. And Ojah Shia, a baby in your muscle. Now, what you remember, Pai said, Ojah, a baby in your muscle. A baby in your muscle. The guy just entered into the scene from obscurity. We don't know where he's coming from. But he's making a bold declaration. And he's saying that as the Lord God of Israel lives. Now, Israel thought that God was dead. But Elijah was saying that my God is not dead. My God lives. They have resorted to the worship of Baal. They have followed the direction of Jezebel. And they are worshiping Baal. They believe that Baal is the God of productivity. Baal is the God of rain. Baal is the God who brings everything. He brings everything. So they were worshiping Baal. They thought God is there. Obviously, Yamil, Yamil, who you are.
Amen.
I don't pay Yamil, who you are.
Amen.
When Yamia was summoned, or Yamia or Tiasi. Hallelujah. Yamil or Tiasi. Yamil on Trump, Yamil on who? Or that's what I am. And the man is saying that as the Lord God of Israel lives, you guys are thinking that God is dead. Now, sometimes you can be in the church all right. You'll be coming to church all right. You'll be participating in everything of the church. But sometimes within you, you'll feel that God is dead. Church becomes some kind of ritual for your life. But in those 7 days, we bring any kind of rituals in your life.
Amen.
You begin to move to the supernatural. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You believe that the God that you serve is a God who is a living.
Amen.
The God who answers by fire.
Amen.
Amen. Nyamia odi ocha eti yenso. Nyamia oye ye pisa ye. Nyamia oye sentrene. May this God answer your prayer by fire. God is not dead. When you read Proverbs chapter 13 verse 12, the Bible saying that when hope is being deferred, it makes the heart sick. When hope is deferred, it makes the heart sick. But a longing for fear is a tree of life. Hello?
Amen.
When hope is deferred, it makes the heart what? Sick. Sometimes, when you have trusted God, you have put your hope in God, you are looking unto God, you have prayed to God, you are expecting God, and things are delayed. Things are being denied. Sometimes you feel like, I get with your Messiah, Messiah, Then hope has been deferred.
Amen.
Would you get to turn in us when it has swallowed? I think turn in us. Or is it Ebasa? Sometimes you are expecting God. You have gone to the place where you need to marry, but things are not happening. Hope is being deferred. Because everybody around you is being married around the same age, but you are crossing the border gradually. Gradually. Ukroso. As a DNA check. Then your heart begins to get sick. And that's why they said, Obiko Mayaria. O Nyamia or Sanyama Yariano. O Cha and Sanyama Yariano. May the Lord bring life into every heart.
Amen.
So I believe that the people of Israel, they have gone into apostasy because hope has been deferred. It is one thing I mean, can you? They don't feel God anymore. They think that God is dead. God is not alive. But Elijah comes into the scene and he says that as the Lord God of Israel is, in whom I stand. No, he was standing before Ahab at that time, but he was saying that I am standing before God. Physically, he was standing before Ahab, but spiritually, he was standing before God. Hello?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There will be no rain on you during these few years except at my word. Because Bible actually says when the people become so disobedient, God will close their heavens. And Elijah just tapped into the word of God. And he acted on the word of God. He declared on the word of God, and it happened.
Amen.
This week, when you pray on the word of God, it will perform.
Amen.
But when you speak in the word of God, it will take place.
Amen.
Now, Adiana Loki, Kukro, heavens, Kukro, Naloki, locked. So, for about 3.5 years, there have been no rain, there have been no dew. This man carries some power.
Amen.
He was not just ordinary.
That's right.
He was somebody who had connection with God.
Right.
In this 7 days, may the Lord connect you to himself.
Amen.
That you will not speak words of men, but you speak words from above.
Amen.
If you believe it, shout a big amen.
Amen.
So they have been drought. They think that Elijah is causing trouble. Then one day, Elijah said, okay, I am the only prophet left. The prophets of Baal, they are about 450 people. Now, let's go for a contest.
Right.
We're going to make an offering. We're going to expect the God who answered by fire. So the Bible says that when we go to the chapter 18, let's read a little bit from 1 Kings chapter 18. Let's start reading from the verse 26. We'll be praying very soon. Tonight we are praying, we are closing at 8:30. Make sure we close at 8:30. Amen. Oh, amen.
Amen.
Verse 26. So they prepared one of the bulls and placed it on the altar. Then they called on the name of Baal from morning until noontime, shouting, "Oh Baal, please answer us." But there was no reply of any kind. Then they danced, hobbling around the altar that they made. About noontime, Elijah began mocking them. "You will have to shout louder."
Yes.
He scoffed, "For surely he is a god. Perhaps he is daydreaming or is relieving himself. Or maybe he is away on a trip or is sleeping and needs to be awakened." So they shouted louder. And following their normal customs, they cut themselves with knives and saw until the blood gushed out. They ran all afternoon until the time of the evening sacrifice. But still, there was no sound, no reply, no response. Then Elijah called to the people, "Come over here." They all crowded around him, and he repaired the altar of the Lord that has been torn down. When he was giving them the chance, nothing happened. They did everything that they could do. Nothing happened. Elijah said, "It is enough. You have tried so many things, but tonight you are trying the God that answered by fire."
Amen.
You have tried so many solutions. You have trusted in so many people. But tonight, I want you to encourage you to trust in the God that answered by fire.
Amen.
So the one thing that Elijah did was that he said that he repaired the broken altar. In those 7 days, may your altar be repaired.
Amen.
Now the altar is a place of connectivity with God and man. Sometimes when you live the ordinary life, your spiritual altar gets damaged and gets broken. The New Testament believer must have a personal altar, because the believer is a sacrifice of God. So daily, you must be on fire for God.
Amen.
Because when you read the book of Leviticus, it says that the fire on the altar must be burning.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The fire on the altar must be what?
Amen.
Is it the beer or just the divya? Is it the beer? Amen. Or just the divya? Divya. And you know, Afarimu can also know. They say, temple, they have said, anyway, you Afarimu can say, divya, no be banu. Na oja, Afarimu can also. Sacrifices now when it happens like that, it brings the presence of God daily.
Oh, wow.
But the New Testament believer, we don't need to do that, because we are the spiritual sacrifice.
Yes.
And we must have a spiritual altar where we always feel the fire burning in our life.
Amen.
And it's a matter, careful. Now I'm going to hear who I am. You will need any ordinary life. This busy life. This entertainment life. A life where everything happens. If you're not careful, you may not even say a minute to pray. Because it's a busy life. America, it's a busy life. You wake up in the morning. You do this, you do that. You got to do that. You got to pass here. You got to move here. And by the time you realize, another day is gone. A busy life, full of entertainment. So many things will take your attention. But tonight, we are plugging ourselves.
Amen.
In this 7 days, we are plugging ourselves.
Amen.
We are disconnecting ourselves from the world.
Amen.
So that we can be on fire for God.
Amen.
So that there will be fire on our altar.
Amen.
So the first thing that Elijah did was that he must repair the broken altar. In this 7 days, if there is any broken altar, may it be repaired in the name of Jesus. So we never saw a pipe or crunkron yet. I confirm what? So that's 7 days, you know. So that's what we get you.
Amen.
So if you home, and tell me confirm what? Your own prayer says 7 days, or tell me something of you.
Amen.
Till the Namie Cassette, Namie Boo Baby. Now, Ben said, Sir, as soon as you are, Edward, or come in your baby. Some people you don't get it. And Mama Matthew, as soon as you say, Mutua, or come in your day. As soon as you muka. It's a place where they set fire and cook. It's like in America. It's like where we have what? Our fire.
Firehouse. Fireplace.
The fireplace. But sometimes it's electrical, so we don't see it real. In the real sense, it must be fire or natural flame. That is, you use wood and fire. That is the natural world. But in America, they make it so electronic, so you don't see it well. Now, this is where the strength or the heat of the house is, bringing heat to the whole house. So when you go to the traditional area, in the traditional setting, where they use wood and fire to cook, when there is no fire in that... how do you say the switch stove, right? When there is no fire in it, any animal can just go there and sleep. That place is not meant for animals to sleep. It's not meant for the dog. And he said, "Okay, I'm telling you what. I'm not going to remind them. I'm not going to remind you. Why you're not here? I'm not going to know. Oh, one kasa, no problem. No, I bet them. When you're the other." Now, what can you say? Yes. So, I will let you have power in your fear. Now, the God who answered by fire, may he bring fire into our lives.
Amen.
So, he repaired the altar. When the altar is repaired, the presence of God will come back.
Amen.
When your life is really positioned before God, God will visit you again.
Amen.
Sometimes ago, you really feel that if you were on fire for God, you could see dreams and it happened. If you speak, you pray, and people get healed. And then in Naira, as on the Fiado, never be the real room, or Jano Adu, now I want to be a vampire, sir. And Rabbi Opa or Tafu Flomera. You minister, and lives are being touched. You sing, and lives are being transformed. Everything that you do is on fire from God. And then you have a sister, Omato. But in our church, you are never a devil from God. You see, when you lead the ordinary life, you become so miserable. So in the parable of the 10 virgins, when you read the verse 8, Matthew 25, verse 8, in the Bible, I see now, a man knew now, the virgins, you know, five of them were wise, five of them were what? Foolish. They were not just foolish, so many of them some. They were so engaged in ordinary life. They were in the church, all right. When we go to church, they go to church. When we sing, they sing. Whatever we do, they partake in it. But they were so engaged in ordinary life. Their altar had been broken, but they are in the church. Now, as a prayer, so you know, I don't go catching yourself on the Pamachel. My name. Crazy in the Kakra, and you can hear him do. That is so sad. You can hear him do. And you will be coming here do one. And I'll never forget him. You will not go and beg it anymore.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you have fire on your altar.
Yes.
Amen. Verse 31. He took the 12 stones. One to represent each of the tribe of Israel. And he used the stones to rebuild the altar in the name of the Lord. Then he dug a trench around the altar, large enough to hold about 3 gallons. He piled wood on the altar, cut the bulls into pieces, and laid the pieces on the wood. Then he said, fill 4 large jars with water, and pour water over the offering and the wood. After they have done this, he said, do the same thing again. When they were finished, he said, now do it a 3rd time. So they did it a 3rd time. And the water ran around the altar and even filled the trench. At the evening time of the offering, the evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet walked up to the altar and prayed. I say, altar, no problem. So now he goes to the altar and he begins to pray. I believe that God for the past 3 days has rebuilt your altar.
Amen.
And from today going, every prayer that will pray, it will work.
Amen.
Heaven will respond.
Amen.
Because your altar has been repaired.
Amen.
The presence of God is now coming.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now he goes to the altar that has been repaired. The bomb by yourself. 7 days. Yes. Sometimes you are looking for a prophet, but you are a prophet yourself.
Amen.
The people that we think they are so supernatural. How many people do you need to say? That is why the Bible says that Elijah was a man of light passion. Elijah, he had repaired the broken altar. He know how to connect with God. And you may say, we are moving you up, so you
know.
You begin to speak and it will happen. Because you know the way of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So he went to the altar and he prayed. Oh Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, prove today. Somebody say, prove today.
Prove today.
Oh, can you prove today?
Prove today.
That you are God in Israel. So you're getting it right. They thought that the God of Israel is dead. Okay? But see, prove yourself to God. This week God will prove himself.
Amen.
That I have done all this at your command. Lord, answer me. Answer me so that the people may know that you are Lord. So these people may know that you are Lord and God, and that you have brought them back to yourself. Father, in the 7 days, may the Lord bring people who have been fed. Their hearts are getting sick. People are leaving the church because they feel that nothing is happening. But you know, sometimes the trap that people fall into, and you don't want to say, oh, the circumstances of life drives them. Now, if you don't know what to see in him, on person God in who ship. That's not in who ship. And you may already obey Chia by your sinner. So who do want for foreign ever be a rather than Chia by your sinner? Prove to that you are God and you are bringing the people back to yourself. Verse 38, then we pray. Immediately, someone say immediately.
Immediately.
The fire of the Lord flashed down from heaven. And bring up the young bull, the wood, the stone, and the dust. It's even lit. Someone say it's even lit. All the water in the trench. And when the people saw it, they fell face down on the ground and cried. The Lord, He is God. Yes, He is God.
Amen.
He is good.
Oh, the Lord is good.
Oh, He is good.
All His mercy shall endure.
Hallelujah. He is good. He is good. The Lord is good.
Oh,
Yes. a heavy tonsil. Baby, I wish I a super catonsil.
Jesus.
Sometimes you may have some skills. You may have some qualifications.
Yes.
But no one recognizes you. But tonight we pray in the name of
Jesus. Jesus.
Yes.
May the fire of God
pray
with
you. May the fire, may the fire, may the fire.
Lift up your voice and pray.
Lift up the fire, may the fire, may the fire.
To consume the wood deposit something new. But for the fire to consume the stones. The stones are impossible things in life. Tonight you want to lift up a prayer.
Yes.
For the fire to consume water. It's not ordinary. Water is not meant for fire to consume. It's water that must always quench
fire.
But for fire to consume water, there have been an irreverence.
Yes.
There have been a change.
Yes.
Tonight in the service, the impossibility will be taken away. The thing that never works, there will be a miracle. Lift up your prayer. Lift up your voice and pray. Anything that is impossible. Anything that is impossible. Anything that is impossible. Tonight we pray. The fire that consumes the world. The fire that consumes the world. Anything that is impossible, we pray in the name of Jesus. The unbeaten God, we are closing for tonight.
Yes, Lord.
But you are not going the same.
Jesus.
You must carry the fire in you.
Oh, yes.
I want you to make declarations.
Yes.
In the next 1 minute, we are making bold declarations.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We begin to overturn certain things.
Reverse it.
Elijah said that as the Lord God of Israel is, there will be no dew, there will be no rain.
Yes, 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 yes.
Except at my word. Tonight you carry the word of God.
Jesus.
Tonight you carry the power of God.
Jesus.
Begin to make some bold declaration. Begin to declare certain things in your life. Declare certain things. In the name of Jesus. We declare in the name of Jesus. You shall marry. Say, Obisa will be Obisa will be what? We declare in the name of Jesus. You shall live. You shall live. You shall live. You shall live. According to the word of God. You shall live, you will not die.
Yes.
You will be the beggar of the tent. Somebody make a declaration to me. I declare upon my children. I declare upon the wife. I declare upon the word of God. I declare upon the church. I declare in the name of Jesus. By the word of God. 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 We pray in the name of Jesus. No weapon, passion against us. to destroy. They come against us with destruction. That's like my death. It's never been destruction. That's like my death. In the name of Jesus, we shall prosper. Father, tonight we are before you. We have repaired a broken altar. And now we have positioned ourselves in your presence. Tonight, may your fire come one again. May the fire that consumes, may it come one again. May the fire that is able to reveal, may the fire fall once again.
Amen.
We are just before you, O God. Elijah said that may they know that you are the God that lives. Tonight we declare that people think that you are dead. We are here saying that you are alive.
Amen.
If hope has been deferred and the heart has become sick, and people feel that God cannot do it anymore. He's only the God of the past, but not the God of the present. Tonight by your word. Tonight by your word. Tonight by your word. Yes, Lord. We declare in the name of Jesus. We declare in the name of Jesus. May you be a God in our time. May you show yourself by fire. May you bring a testimony in our life. May you bring a miracle in our life. May you change the order of nature. Fire that consumes water. May the order of nature begin to change. And people may know that we serve a living God. We thank you tonight. This is just the beginning. We know that by the end of Sunday, there will be a great testimony and miracle. And we will continue to praise your mighty name. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus, for answering us by fire. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Now may the God who answered by fire, the God who still lives, the God who works miracles, the God who has been accredited for signs, wonders, and miracles, may this God continue to bless you.
Amen.
May he continue to rekindle his fire in your life. May his blazing face shine before you.
Amen.
May the Lord keep you. May the Lord protect you.
Amen.
May the Lord preserve you.
Amen.
Now and forevermore. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.